spokesperson, Congressman Erin Tañada. Adele and Linda.
Thanks, Tony. Well, Congressman Erin Tañada, thank you for coming and good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Linda and Adele.
Good to see you again. Well, Congressman, what do you expect for the cross-examination of former Manila Mayor Lito Atienza this afternoon? Will it be the prosecution which will cross-examine, or will it be the senator judges?
Well, there will be a few questions coming from the prosecution, because mm-hmm. remember that Mayor Lito Atienza brought in some documents mm-hmm. to have marked, no? mm-hmm. and the prosecution before the Lenten break wanted to study these documents. So there will be some questions with regard to these documents, but not that lengthy. Mm-hmm. And after that, we can discharge. The defense can discharge Mayor Atienza.
Mm-hmm. The prosecution or the defense is looking at the possibility of, you know, wrapping up the presentation of evidence in 1 or 2 weeks, 2 weeks at the most. How long do you think will the rebuttal portion mm-hmm. or stage of the prosecution will take?
I don't think it will take even that long. Mm-hmm. So far, we haven't seen any important issue to rebut at this point. Mm-hmm. Of course, over the break, the 10 million came up, no? Mm-hmm. So we're studying that angle. Maybe at the most, not more than 3 days or mm-hmm. at least a 4-day week, we'll be able to finish our rebuttal. Mm-hmm.
You mentioned that you're studying the angle of the mm-hmm. 10 million. You know, if you decide, I think the last time I talked to Congressman Kimbo, he said the prosecution has not yet decided yes. on whether or not to present the matter here in the Senate, before the Senate Impeachment Court. If you do decide to bring it up here, how do you intend to present it? Because pinag-uusapan nga namin ni Adele kanina, usually yung rebuttal mm-hmm. ng defense presentation is dapat tinake up din ng defense yung issue na yun bago nyo itake
well,
up sa rebuttal.
Well, if we do it this way, we can always mention that part of the 10 million dollar deposits mm-hmm. are part of the deposits also in the PS Bank mm-hmm. account. So mm-hmm. remember that we tried to have that PS Bank account dollar account open, but there was a TRO issued by the yes. Supreme Court. Mm-hmm. So in that angle, we're looking at the possibility of bringing that in through that issue.
Since you still have a reservation
yes.
on the dollar deposits.
Yes.
And all. But how will you go around the TRO? Because the Supreme Court has stopped.
Well, what we're looking at is we're awaiting maybe the report of the Ombudsman.
Mm-hmm.
And once the Ombudsman makes that report and makes that public, then we can submit that report to the impeachment court for their perusal. And I'm sure all the information with regard to the dollar account without even touching the PS Bank.
PS Bank,
the other which is not subject to the TRO.
So the other dollar accounts yes. ang titingnan ninyo.
Yeah, just to I guess help explain to our viewers, no?
Mm-hmm.
Because the TRO was actually issued in favor of PS Bank.
Yes.
Because they were claiming that presenting evidence on these dollar accounts mm-hmm. violates the law on dollar accounts, which has a very broad protection. So that's a good point raised by Congressman Erin, that mm-hmm. if the argument can be made that this 10 million does not refer to a PS Bank account,
yes. mm-hmm.
but rather to some other account, then that wouldn't fall under the TRO. But still,
yes.
of course, the argument is that it's still a dollar account, and therefore you cannot still present it in any proceeding.
Well, the thing here is, will Chief Justice say that those other dollar accounts are his?
Mm,
if
yeah.
he does not say so, then the TRO does not cover also those mm-hmm. dollar accounts.
Mm-hmm. That's right. So, well, I guess the final arbiter here really would be the Senate.
Senate, yes.
There will be the gatekeepers in regard that. I'm curious, when LJ was talking to you, Congressman Erin, you weren't sure that you would be presenting rebuttal witnesses. You weren't very categorical about it. Has the prosecution had a caucus mm. and talked about presenting, actually making that decision? Because, of course, if you do that, then you also open the door to the defense to present
yes.
sir rebuttal witnesses.
That's true. But at this point in time, studying the evidence presented by the defense,
mm-hmm.
There's still no need to make okay. that decision, because our rebuttal would be dependent on what the evidence they present. But based on our our study over the Holy Week break, there seems to be still at this point no need to present rebuttal evidence.
Mm-mm. And then, of course, Manila Mayor or former Manila Mayor Lito Atienzo will be talking again about the Basagidote transactions, you know.
Yes.
And before we adjourned or took a break, there was discussion of presenting some members of mm-hmm. the Basagidote family before the impeachment court. Have you already decided on that, or has it been abandoned?
No, it hasn't been abandoned, but at this point, it's still there. Mm-hmm. We still want to determine, because if it's just only Mayor Lito Atienza, he's just claiming that they paid and that's mm-hmm. it. Now, we await if they will present Cristina Corona.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if they present Cristina Corona and she touches on this issue, then the possibility of bringing in the other directors of the Basagidote Enterprises would be there.
Congressman, we're not sure if Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales will submit or turn over to the Senate her own findings in investigating the dollar accounts or alleged dollar accounts of the Chief Justice. And all. So what will the prosecution do? Will you ask the Supreme Court to subpoena the documents, subpoena Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales to testify? What will be the strategy there?
That's a strategy we will not reveal at this point.
I should not have said the word strategy. Okay. What will be the tack?
Well, no, we're looking at the possibility, of course. The possibility is always that the prosecution will file a motion to the impeachment court to allow us to subpoena these documents. And of course, we expect the defense to object.
Mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
at the end, like Adele will always say, at the end of the day, the gatekeepers will make that decision.
Mm-hmm.
But again, it is important for us to look at what the Ombudsman has
mm-hmm.
in order to really ascertain the values that are indicated in the other dollar accounts, which the Chief Justice up to this day refuses to claim as his own.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if that is true, mm-hmm. then why is he afraid to go to the Senate mm-hmm. under oath, say it is not mine?
Mm-hmm. Okay, before in the earlier part of the trial, there was an attempt also to have Associate Justice Maria mm-hmm. Lourdes Sereno testify here for Article 7.
Yes.
You know? So there were initial talks with her because the Senate said it should be an invitation.
Yes.
So in the case of the Ombudsman, have there been talks with her or representations made to her for the possibility of testifying in impeachment court?
Not yet at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Not yet. Because if we also look at it, I think there is still no report, mm-hmm. final mm-hmm. report mm-hmm. of what the Ombudsman is doing right now. And the discussion is, do we wait for the report
mm-hmm.
or even raw without even waiting for the Chief Justice to reply? Can we already ask her to testify?
Mm-hmm.
So that those are the things that we have to discuss.
Mm-hmm.
LJ, I'm just curious about Secretary De Lima
mm-hmm.
because the prosecution seems to be quite insistent that because you have been questioning the subpoena. Have you filed a formal motion to quash the subpoena that's been issued?
Yes,
against,
there was a formal motion filed last week, but mm-hmm. we've heard that the Senate would deny our motion to quash mm-hmm. and allow the recalling of Secretary De Lima. That, I don't know if my information is correct, but mm-hmm. that's what we heard.
That's what we heard also.
Yeah.
But mm-hmm. could you explain? Because I guess for the viewing public, they're wondering why wouldn't you want her to testify some more?
Because for us, the defense had all the leeway
okay.
when Secretary De Lima was presented to cross-examine. As a matter of mm-hmm. fact, when we would always raise an objection, mm-hmm. she's under cross, mm-hmm. or they would always say that we're testing the credibility of the secretary. So they had all the leeway to ask all the questions.
Mm-hmm.
So we are thinking that if they forgot to ask a particular question, this is not, this is improper procedure to do it.
But
so, like I said, again, if the Senate says that we'll allow her to come mm-hmm. back, then we would accept it.
Mm-hmm. But of course, correct me if I'm wrong, but they're not bringing her back for more cross-examination.
No.
They're bringing her back as their own witness.
Yes.
And although
yes.
There's a possibility that she might be a hostile witness.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So anyway, we'll see you later when the trial resumes. Thank you very much, Congressman
Erin
Tañada. I will see more of you. Tony, it's back to you.
All right, thank you, Linda and Adele.
Meanwhile, carefully. I commend your ignorance, Mr. Administrator. You are guilty of negligence. Not only of negligence, but of gross negligence. Either you or the prosecution, nobody else.
Former Manila Mayor Lito Atienza was the last witness to testify before Congress took a Lenten break. Atienza testified the Manila government paid Mrs. Corona 34.7 million pesos in 2001 for the purchase of a property owned by Basagidote Enterprises. The firm is owned by Mrs. Corona's family. The defense said the cash was not declared in Corona's salen because it was not his money. But the prosecution argued Mrs. Corona treated the money as her own and therefore should have been in the Chief Justice's salen. Atienza is expected to undergo cross-examination.
2002. Every year thereafter.
All right, and let's go back to our Senate studio with our colleagues Linda and Adele. We'll be joined by prosecution spokesperson Congressman Erin Tañada. Adele and Linda.
Thanks, Tony. Well, Congressman Erin Tañada, thank you for coming and good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Linda and Adele.
Good to see you again. Well, Congressman, what do you expect for the cross-examination of former Manila Mayor Lito Atienza this afternoon? Will it be the prosecution which will cross-examine or will it be the senator judges?
Well, there will be a few questions coming from the prosecution because remember that Mayor Lito Atienza brought in some documents to have marked, no? And the prosecution before the Lenten break wanted to study these documents. So there will be some questions with regard to these documents, but not that lengthy. Mm-hmm. And after that, we can discharge. The prosecution and the defense can discharge Mayor Atienza.
Mm-hmm. The prosecution or the defense is looking at the possibility of, you know, wrapping up the presentation of evidence in 1 or 2 weeks, 2 weeks at the most. How long do you think will the rebuttal portion or stage of the prosecution will take?
I don't think it will take even that long. Mm-hmm. So far, we haven't seen any important issue to rebut at this point. Of course, over the break, the 10 million came up, no? Mm-hmm. So we're studying that angle. So maybe at the most, not more than 3 days or at least a 4-day week, we'll be able to finish our rebuttal. Mm-hmm.
You mentioned that you're studying the angle of the 10 million. Ano? If you decide, I think the last time I talked to Congressman Kimbo, he said the prosecution has not yet decided on whether or not to present the matter here in the Senate, before the Senate Impeachment Court. If you do decide to bring it up here, how do you intend to present it? Because pinag-uusapan nga namin ni Adele kanina, usually yung rebuttal ng defense presentation is dapat tinake up din ng defense yung issue na yun bago nyo itake
well,
up sa rebuttal.
Well, if we do it this way, we can always mention that part of the 10 million dollar deposits are part of the deposits also in the PS Bank account. So remember that we tried to have that PS Bank account dollar account open, but there was a TRO issued by the Supreme Court. So in that angle, we're looking at the possibility of bringing that in through that issue.
Since you still have a reservation on the dollar deposits. And all. Yes. But how will you go around the TRO? Because the Supreme Court has stopped.
Well, what we're looking at is awaiting maybe the report of the Ombudsman. Mm-hmm. And once the Ombudsman makes that report and makes that public, then we can submit that report to the impeachment court for their perusal. And I'm sure all the information with regard to the dollar account without even touching the PS Bank. The other which is not subject to the TRO.
So the other dollar accounts ang titingnan ninyo.
Yeah, just to I guess help explain to our viewers, no? Mm-hmm. Because the TRO was actually issued in favor of PS Bank.
Yes.
Because they were claiming that presenting evidence on these dollar accounts violates the law on dollar accounts, which has a very broad protection. So that's a good point raised by Congressman Erin, that if the argument can be made that this 10 million does not refer to a PS Bank account, but rather to some other account, then that wouldn't fall under the TRO. But still, of course, the argument is that it's still a dollar account, and therefore you cannot still present it in any proceeding.
Well, the thing here is, will Chief Justice say that those other dollar accounts are his? If he does not say so, then the TRO does not cover also those dollar accounts.
And that's right. So, well, I guess the final arbiter here really would be the Senate.
There
will be the gatekeepers in regard that. I'm curious, when LJ was talking to you, Congressman Erin, you weren't sure that you would be presenting rebuttal witnesses. You weren't very categorical about it. Has the prosecution had a caucus and talked about presenting, actually making that decision? Because, of course, if you do that, then you also open the door to the defense to present surrebuttal witnesses.
That's true. Because, but at this point in time, studying the evidence presented by the defense, there's still no need to make that decision. Because our rebuttal would be dependent on what the evidence they present. But based on our study over the Holy Week break, there seems to be still at this point no need to present rebuttal evidence.
And then, of course, Manila Mayor or former Manila Mayor Lito Atienzo will be talking again about the Basagidote transactions, you know. And before we adjourned or took a break, there was discussion of presenting some members of the Basagidote family before the impeachment court. Have you already decided on that, or has it been abandoned?
No, it hasn't been abandoned, but at this point, it's still there. We still want to determine, because if it's just only Mayor Lito Atienza, he's just claiming that they paid and that's it. Now, we await if they will present Cristina Corona. Now, if they present Cristina Corona and she touches on this issue, then the possibility of bringing in the other directors of the Basagidote enterprises would be there.
Congressman, we're not sure if Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales will submit or turn over to the Senate her own findings in investigating the dollar accounts or alleged dollar accounts of the Chief Justice. And all. So what will the prosecution do? Will you ask the Supreme Court to subpoena the documents, subpoena Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales to testify? What will be the strategy there?
That's a strategy we will not reveal at this point.
I should not have said the word strategy. Okay. What would be the tack?
Well, no, we're looking at the possibility. Of course, the possibility is always that the prosecution will file a motion to the impeachment court to allow us to subpoena these documents, and of course we expect the defense to object. So at the end, like Adele will always say, at the end of the day, the gatekeepers will make that decision. But again, it is important for us to look at what the Ombudsman has in order to really ascertain the values that are indicated in the other dollar accounts, which the Chief Justice up to this day refuses to claim as his own. Now, if that is true, then why is he afraid to go to the Senate under oath, say it is not mine?
Okay. Well, before in the earlier part of the trial, there was an attempt also to have Associate Justice Maria Lourdes Sereno testify here for Article 7. You know? So there were initial talks with her because the Senate said it should be an invitation. So in the case of the Ombudsman, have there been talks with her or representations made to her for the possibility of testifying in impeachment court?
Not yet at this point. Not yet. Because if we also look at it, I think there is still no report, final report of what the Ombudsman is doing right now. And the discussion is, do we wait for the report or even raw, without even waiting for the Chief Justice to reply, can we already ask her to testify? So those are the things that we have to discuss.
LJ, I'm just curious about Secretary De Lima, because the prosecution seems to be quite insistent that, because you have been questioning the subpoena. Have you filed a formal motion to quash the subpoena that's been issued?
Yes,
against,
there was a formal motion filed last week, but we've heard that the Senate would deny our motion to quash and allow the recalling of Secretary De Lima. That, I don't know if my information is correct, but that's what we heard.
That's what we heard also. Yeah.
But could you explain, because I guess for the viewing public, they're wondering why wouldn't you want her to testify some more?
Because for us, the defense had all the leeway when Secretary De Lima was presented to cross-examine. As a matter of fact, when we would always raise an objection, she's under cross, or they would always say that we're testing the credibility of the secretary. So they had all the leeway to ask all the questions. So we are thinking that if they forgot to ask a particular question, this is improper procedure to do it. But so, like I said, again, if the Senate says that we'll allow her to come back, then we would accept it.
But of course, correct me if I'm wrong, but they're not bringing her back for more cross-examination.
No.
They're bringing her back as their own witness.
Yes,
and although
yes.
There's a possibility that she might be a hostile witness.
Yes, yes.
Okay. So anyway, we'll see you later when the trial resumes. Thank you very much, Congressman
Erin
Tañada.
Yeah.
I will see more of you. Tony, it's back to you.
All right. Thank you, Linda and Adele.